new releases.
Okay. Let's see here. I have been playing some Golf Story for the Switch. That came out like after last week's show, but it's included in this week's new releases. That is a lot of fun. It's a overhead, think like, I don't know, Zelda, 16-bit Zelda type of looking thing. Mm-hmm. But it is a RPG based around golfing. And it's got a very cute, like, way that it tells the story and kind of breaks the fourth wall sometimes. And it's not just like playing rounds of golf. Like, you're actually going out and exploring the golf courses and talking to the characters, and they have stupid things that need to be done and taken care of. And you do that by hitting golf balls at things or hitting things that aren't golf balls, or like, you got to feed some turtles or something. So you hit some food out to the turtles. and then the turtles become your friends. And then if you hit a golf ball into like the circles where the turtles live, then the turtles will come up and the golf ball hits off the top of their shell and doesn't go in the water. That type.
That's what turtles are for.
It sounds kind of fun.
Yeah, no, it's really fun. And like all the different worlds, I on world four, I think they all have like different themes. Just like an RPG would have, or any kind of video game would have. You have like one city's like way up in the air with birds flying around. And the, what was the second one? The second one, it was kind of jungly with, that's where the turtles lived and everything. It's very, very cool. It's got the whole upgrade structure in there. You're getting XP for doing all this stuff. You get money and you can buy new gear. It's very well done. Like, so well done that I wonder why Nintendo hasn't gone this route. I mean, they had the long time ago, that Mario Golf that had kind of the RPG elements to it back on Game Boy Color, I believe. But like, I'm just playing this and thinking like, how is Nintendo not stuck their characters into something like this?
Maybe Golf Story too.
Yeah. It's
only $15 too. Huh?
Only $15. It's a lot of fun.
Cool. Oh, single player only?
I would assume so. Yes. Okay. I mean, it's a very story driven game. I don't know if there's a mode in there for multiplayer where you just play golf against each other or not. Could be.
Cool. Golf Story. What else we got?
We have for Xbox, we have Cuphead. I guess Xbox and PC. Mm-hmm. And I know both you and I, Cheapy, have been playing Cuphead.
I took the plunge.
Uh-huh.
I'm able to get past levels.
Me too.
But I'm sure it's going to get to the point where I can't get past them.
You think so? I don't know. Everything
really
seems
hard.
So pattern based to me on this that it's, if you're able to recognize pattern and do old style platforming type of things, it seems like you should be fine. I mean, it's basically for the most part a boss battle game,
right?
And there's very few, at least so far. I've only played. I'm almost done with the first island. I guess there's. It looks like there's three islands. Is that right?
I don't know.
It's somewhere in that. It's either three or four based upon the achievement list that I saw. And so far, there's been two platforming levels. And the rest have been boss battles. And then there's been one like flying in an airplane level.
So do I want to get this game or not?
No.
Okay.
You don't. I don't think there's much.
You do feel good though when you beat a level, though.
You do, but I don't think this is Wombat's thing. Like, you have to, you're gonna have to repeat some stuff over and over again. And
I could do other things. If I want to feel good, I have other things I could do.
Really?
You would like that you buy upgrades and can, add those to your character and swap them out and stuff. But I just don't think this is something that you would enjoy.
The animation
obviously is fantastic.
I know, and I watched some Let's Plays, and I'm like, this game looks so nice. It's a shame I'm never going to play it. But
you know,
I think you're fine
bucks.
Just watching it on YouTube for you.
Yeah, but I don't want to spend 20. I have other things I could spend $20 on.
Right, I get it.
Like I feel like I would enjoy Golf Story more than Cuphead.
Yeah, definitely. I think that makes sense for you. You can play that on the train. There's very few things that I've had to retry on Golf Story. You progress as you play pretty easily.
Yeah.
Cuphead, I just don't think it's for you, Wombat. I like it. I was hoping there would be more platforming than what there is. Right now, at least through the first level, it's just a lot of dodging.
Does the game get by?
Watching boss.
Does the game really get by on the art style? Is that kind of what saves this game? Like, if it was, say, a 16-bit style looking game.
Yes.
Would we even be talking about it?
It would lose some of the appeal, certainly, but I think the mechanics... Yeah, a lot of it. The mechanics are still solid, but it's like, okay, here's the boss.
And I know that's a loaded question, by the way. I know it's a loaded question.
Yeah. But it's like, here's the boss battle where this blob, like, jumps up in the air and you have to, like, run underneath him so he doesn't hit you. It's like, all stuff that you're very familiar with. It's all Mario boss battles so far, except instead of jumping on things' heads, you're shooting them. It's really neat looking. Like, it's definitely visually striking to watch.
The music is great. I think you know, people compare it a lot to like old school NES games, hard ones. The biggest difference besides the art style, obviously, is that the levels are short, so you don't get super duper frustrated because you're not, it's not like, oh my God, I have to go back and play like another, you know, 5 minutes to get to this checkpoint or something like that. It's all the levels, I think, you know, you can beat them in like 2 minutes, as far as, at least so far. So no, I like it so far, and I'm still playing it.
Did you change up the controls? I remapped the controls because I felt like there was just way too much going on the face buttons.
No, I'm going to do that, though. You said shoot with the right trigger and dash with the left trigger.
Yeah, I think that helps me a lot because I was trying to do the dash, which is mapped to Y, and the jumping is mapped to A, and shooting was X. Like, it was, everything was like right by each other.
Yeah.
There was no way to like do a jump and a dash very precisely because you were having to move your finger from jump to dash real quick.
It's not a great game to play when you're sick because like you're just going to be sweating more.
Maybe that is good to get get the germs out.
Get the germs.
With sweat.
Maybe. I'm sweating a lot right now, in case you're wondering. Anything else this week besides FIFA's out? We don't play that. Anything else there?
Battle Chasers, I guess, came out. We saw that at E3. That was pretty nice looking. That was a turn-based RPG.
Cool.
And Dragon's Dogma is back out now on modern consoles.
Sweet. All right, then.